So we're going to continue our discussion about high performance. But today, before we go into high performance, I've been asked by clients and a number of people offline about managing themselves in stressful situations. It's all very well to talk about high performance, but how do you manage yourself in stressful situations in the workplace? And a recent study that was done in 2018 says that 85% of UK adults are regularly experiencing stress. And over a third of people in the British workplace, employees in the British workplace, say they feel stressed for at least one full day in every week. Furthermore, 39% of UK adults say that the stress level is above the level at which they find acceptable. So stress is becoming a really important topic. How do you manage stress? Well, my recommendation is it's a bit like medication. Don't treat stress like medication. Don't wait until you get stressed before you do something about it. First and foremost, you know, be open, be honest. Talk to people about it if you're feeling under pressure. Talking about it and communicating almost always improves a stressful situation. And personal experience has taught me that in the past. Don't bottle it up. Talk to colleagues, talk to your peers, talk to your manager, talk to friends, family. If things are too much, do speak out. But practically, what can you do to manage yourself through stress? As an NLP practitioner, there were a number of principles I learned, and at the time when I learned them, they were very useful. I was in a quite stressful job, quite working long hours, I had young children, and it was a really useful series of principles and techniques I learned. So I'm going to share four key tips with you today, four key tips for managing yourself in stressful situations, and I hope they are useful for you. The first is around your posture. So when you start to feel stress, one of the things that happens is you start to close down your body language. You'll notice that your shoulders will come over. You might start to stoop. One of the fastest cures is to think about posture, to stand up straight, put your shoulders back, head up, and look upwards. So our eyes, there's a quote that says our eyes are the windows into our minds in NLP, and they really are. Whenever you're feeling emotions, your eyes will naturally sink down and you will almost go into a position where you're almost trying to access your emotions through your body. One of the fastest ways out of that is to simply stand tall, bring your shoulders back and look up. It's remarkable how effective that is in changing your neurology. So your physiology changes your neurology. And you remember from my last video, this think, feel, act loop, this is where this comes into play. So think about your posture, straighten up. I would advise if you are feeling stressed, stand up. Don't remain sitting if you're sitting down. Stand up, shoulders back, head up, look up, and it will make you feel better straight away. Second thing is breathing. When we feel stressed, we will naturally go into shallow, low breathing rhythms. So as soon as you're aware that you're stressed, up on your feet, look up, shoulders back, deep breaths. If you take 5 to 10 really deep, long breaths, you're reoxygenating your system, your mind, and you'll get a greater sense of clarity, and the stress that you were feeling will dissipate and you'll start to feel almost immediately better. So they're the first two tips. Third tip, we all have an inner voice. And you will recognize this. I don't know whether or not it's something you have given much thought to, but your inner voice will play tricks on you unless you control it. It's a bit like the thoughts that we talked about in the last video. That inner voice is yours to command, but it's only yours to command when you realize it is and then you take control of it. The best thing you can do is to ask yourself a really positive question, something along the lines of, gratitude. What's the thing I'm most grateful for in my life right now? And gratitude as an emotion, we'll talk about daily rituals at some point, but gratitude as an emotion, as an experience, trumps everything else. So if you're feeling stressed, pressure, anxiety, if you switch to gratitude, that reconnection with what you're grateful for in your life will immediately overcome whatever it was you were feeling. So, third tip is control that inner voice, the way to control it is to ask yourself a really empowering question. My question that I ask myself is, what am I most grateful for in my life right now? Immediately soothes, calms, and makes me feel connected to something bigger than the immediate stresses of that situation. Fourth, and possibly the most important tip, this is a long-term tip for controlling yourself and managing yourself through stressful situations, and that is to become more present. So there's a lot of research that shows that mindfulness and becoming present is much more effective in managing stress than anything else you can do. It's really useful in helping you to just regain a sense of perspective, because there's a great quote, no amount of guilt can change the past. No amount of anxiety can shape the future. There is only experiencing the present. And one of the mantras I have to bring myself and reconnect to the present moment is I just remind myself that the past has already happened, the future is mine to write, there is only this present moment. So if you like that, you can have it, it's on me. So no amount of stress and anxiety is going to change the past or the future. You have only this present moment. So I hope you enjoy that. So these four things will make an impact. If you're finding yourself in a situation where you regularly experience stress, like 85% of the adults in the UK, then taking the time to think about these four things, the fourth area, being present, thinking about how do I reconnect with what's happening right here and now. Not what has happened, not what is going to happen, what is happening right here and now is a great antidote to stress. So I hope you found that useful. This is helping you to reconnect with your current performance level. Then we'll move on to some other techniques around higher performance. But this should be useful in getting you grounded in your current performance. I hope you've enjoyed that. If you'd like to comment or connect with me, please feel free. I have a LinkedIn profile which this video will be on. I have a YouTube channel with all of the Focus for Growth Leadership Success Series videos. We have a Facebook page and a community on Facebook as well. So very happy to connect with you if you want to reach out to me in any of those mediums. And I look forward to seeing you on the next Leadership Success Series video from Focus for Growth. Thanks for watching.